Part 2 to the tent set, we are going to express a blanket that naturally drapes on the floor. There may be many ways to do this, and I will explain the pros and cons of each method. First, create a large square pattern, then simulate it and drop it onto the floor. With simulation on, click/drag the pattern to make wrinkles. Now, what you have to think about is the friction on the floor. Once on the floor, the pattern doesn't come off easily due to the friction value. It's not the easiest method to click and drag while it sticks like this. Next, let's make wrinkles with the gravity off and then simulate it. Right-click the pattern in the 3D window, pick the Reset 3D Arrangement option from the drop-down menu. In the 3D window, right-click the empty space and then select the simulation properties from that drop-down menu. In the Properties panel, set gravity to 0 from negative 9800. Set the particle distance to 10 to express more natural wrinkles. Turn on the simulation and click or drag the pattern to crease. Previously, it was more convenient to wrinkle when on the floor. When the desired wrinkles appear, right-click on the pattern to select the Solidify menu. The Solidify menu allows you to simulate the pattern while maintaining its shape. Set the gravity to negative 2000, which is weaker than the default negative 9800 in the Simulation Properties Gravity menu for applying the value of gravity. This allows the pattern to be placed on the floor slowly and smoothly. Simulate onto the floor and then right-click the fabric and select Unsolidify. After you turn on simulation, you can correct the wrinkles again. With the fabric in place, let's look at the shape of the wrinkles according to the fabric properties. Select a fabric item in the fabric window and then select a thick canvas material called cotton canvas from the fabric properties window. If you look at the preview image of that preset, you can see fewer wrinkles here. Set the gravity value of the simulation property back to 0 again and then simulate it to make wrinkles. You can see that the folding shape and size of the wrinkles are different than the basic properties. It's more stiff and angled form of a crease. Solidify the pattern and enter a gravity value of negative 2000, simulate. Simulate again. Modify wrinkles after you use Unsolidify. When you want to smooth wrinkles throughout the whole piece, use the Strengthen option on the pattern's right-click menu. If you have large wrinkles but want to fine-tune them, adjust the sub-properties of the fabric preset. In the Fabric Properties, Preset Subproperties, the bending value is the bending strength of the fabric. Adjust the value from approximately 60 to 30. The simulation shows that the wrinkles are not as dense as before. Let's look at the relationship between gravity and wrinkles. If you increase the gravitational force to negative 4,000, double the current to negative 2,000, the pattern is pressed a little more and stuck to the floor. If you change gravity to negative 9,800, a lot of the area is attached to the floor friction value. This is more evident when the pattern is placed in the air and then dropped onto the floor. When the gravitational value is strong, to reduce the deformation of the pattern, use the Solidify menu to simulate it as we did earlier. Once again, you can see the difference in the floor area compared to when you didn't use the Solidify option. Simulating with a weak gravity value of negative 1000 reduces the amount of wrinkles pressed and allowing for more raised wrinkles. In order to express the draped wrinkles on the floor, adjust the menus such as Gravity, Solidify, Fabric Properties, and Strength.